The theme of peace is central to Christianity and can be found right across the pages of the Bible. Our next song is based on famous words from the Old Testament book of Numbers, written and led by Graham Kendrick. It's called simply, The Peace.
Now may the peace of the Lord be with you. Now may the peace of the Lord be with you, be with you. Now and always, may the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you.
Lambeth Palace, the home of the Archbishop of Canterbury, has had a formal partnership with the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar for 16 years. Their work has inspired this emerging peacemakers forum, organised by and for young people, where young Christians and Muslims with potential to be future leaders explore what they have in common. Now, to some of both faiths, that's a big challenge. But to those who are here, it's a natural expression of their faith.
I hope that you're going to really get stuck in and participate and engage.
To increase understanding between Islam and Christianity, some fear they will have to water down their beliefs. But as the young organiser Georgia May explains, this forum takes a different approach.
You don't have to compromise what you believe in order to engage with others who are very different to you. So especially for young people, for them to be able to come into a space where they can be honest about who they are, real about what they believe, share some of their deepest convictions, whilst also learn to respect and acknowledge that everyone else is going to be doing exactly the same thing.
How to have and create a free space yet prevent any toxic thoughts from emerging.
So you're hoping that the next world leaders are there learning in your forum, the next Martin Luther King, Nelson Mandela, Malala.
Yeah, to be able to see young people rising up saying, I want to be a peacemaker in economics, I want to be a peacemaker in law. You know, it's not that there's just some people are peacemakers. This really is exciting.
When I was growing up as a child, the three closest friends to me had four different faiths, Muslim, Christian, Jewish and atheism.
Islam's not focused on itself. It seeks to promote the good and oppose the bad for the benefit of the whole of society.
This really is exciting. We want to recognise that we all have an identity and a responsibility to be peacemakers and reconcilers, whatever community I live in.
I really believe in grassroots peacemaking between just two friends meeting in a cafe or a small group of people meeting together to talk about faith and how to benefit their community.
I feel like God is teaching me tolerance and acceptance, you know, to be able to accept the fact that, yes, okay, my opinion may not be the same as others, but part of being a Christian is that you would sit down and you would listen, you know, to the stories and the hearts of people.
Well, one of the sessions is taking place behind me, and I think the thing that struck me the most about today is that while there are so many wars around the world and conflicts, there are people who are looking beyond our differences. And when you think about that, there's so much more that unites us than divides us.
Yes, it's great to have similarities and share them together, but it's more of celebrating the differences instead of fighting with each other just because we're doing something differently.
As a British Muslim, and I have like a number of Christian friends who I've grown up with, we haven't had the opportunity to kind of delve into faith and ask these questions that we've had at this forum. And this kind of rare opportunity to do that, you do find that we are pretty much the same.
Today I've learned how peace can come about when you bring people together, be it to listen, to talk, and even to box, and how Christianity and peacemaking go hand in hand.
Next week, the Reverend Kate Botley is at the Goodwood Revival Motoring Festival discovering its Christian links, and we meet three Blue Peter presenters recalling 60 years of inspiring the nation's children.
We end this week with a hymn of unity, telling the story of God's promise to stay with us all, whatever we're going through.
Thank you. Who will be the first unlucky celeb to waltz away from Strictly? The results here on BBC One tonight at 7:15. And later, Jenna Coleman plays a young woman living through a nightmare in The Cry at 9.